have to consider for design of rolling contact bearings. These are the service factors for radial ball bearings. For uniform and steady loads, we have to consider service factor Ks as 1. For light shock loads, we have to consider Ks as 1.5. For moderate shock loads, we have to consider for Ks equal to 2.0. For heavy shock loads, you have to consider Ks as 2.5. And for extreme shock loads, the service factor Ks for radial ball bearings, you have to consider as Ks equal to 3. Okay, these 5 are very important for considering the type of service factor. Okay, these are the values for service factors. Okay. Now, these are the values of dynamically equivalent loaded factors, that is a radial load factor and axial load factors. Here X is the radial load factor, Y is the axial load factor. So by using X and Y values, you have to find out the value of equivalent dynamic load. Okay, so this is, yeah, the question is the rolling contact ball bearing. Here you have to consider rolling contact. Okay, the problem is rolling contact ball bearing. Okay, ball bearing. Okay, now the given values are speed is given, that is n equal to 720 rpm. Okay, and the life of bearing in hours is given. So the life of bearing equal to 24,000 hours. Okay, life of bearing in hours, LH. L refers life, H refers in hours. Okay, life of bearing in hours, LH equal to life of bearing in hours, 24,000 hours. Okay, and the dynamic equivalent load is given, that is a W equal to 1 kilonewton is given. And here we have to find the value of basic dynamic load rating, that is a capital C. Here another one is given, that is the reliability. Our required reliability of the bearing is given, that is R. Reliability means capital R. Capital R equal to 90% reliability. So 90%, you have to convert this 90% into constant value, that is 90 by 100. For removing this percentile, you have to divide with 100. Okay, so 90 by 100 equal to 0.9 is the value of R. Okay, by using these details, you have to find the value of capital C. Okay, now already we know that the life of bearing corresponding to 99% reliability, the formula is L99 is equal to life of bearing in hours. You have to convert this life of bearing in hours into revolutions. So first of all, you have to convert this life of bearing in hours into minutes. That's why you have to multiply with the 60. So you have LH into 60. LH into 60 represents life of bearing in minutes. Then after, you have to convert minutes into revolutions. So already in given data, the revolutions per minute, the speed of the bearing per minute is given, that is 720 revolutions per minute. So 60 into LH minutes are there, totally 60 into LH minutes. Okay, you have to multiply with N, capital N. Okay, then the life of bearing is converted into revolutions. So the total value is equal to life of bearing in revolutions equal to 1036.8 into 10 power 6 revolutions. 10 power 6 revolutions is equal to 1 million revolutions. Okay, 10 power 6 is called million. Okay, 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs revolutions is equal to 1 million revolutions. Okay, now you have to find the life of bearing for corresponding 90% reliability. Okay, so you have to find this value. For finding life of bearing for 90% reliability, already we know the formula for reliability reliability of the bearing. This is the formula for reliability. Okay. Yeah, this is the formula. So L99, the life of bearing L99 equal to L99 by L90 equal to L log E 1 by R99 divided by log E 1 by R90 whole power 1 by B into, these are the adjustment factors already given in our question. So you have to multiply these values 0.9 into 0.85. Okay, the answer is L99 by L90. L99 by L90 equal to this one. Okay, so then after you have to find the value of L90. Okay, we need to find out the value of life of bearing for 90% reliability. So that's why we got the value answer for life of bearing for 90% reliability equal to this value. Okay, the answer for life of bearing in life of bearing for 90% reliability equal to 10,105 into 10 to the power of 6 revolutions. Okay, so this is the life of bearing, expected life of bearing for 90% reliability. Okay, so by using this life, you have to find the value of basic dynamic load rating. Okay, so already we know the formula for basic dynamic load rating. Here capital C is the basic dynamic load rating. Basic dynamic load rating capital C equal to equivalent dynamic load, W is called equivalent dynamic load, into life of bearing, expected life of bearing for 90% reliability divided by 1 million revolutions, that is a 10 power 6 whole power 1 by K. Okay, here already we know the value of K. Okay, this K is a constant for ball bearings and roller bearings. Okay, for ball bearings K equal to 3. Okay, already we have discussed in the previous class. Okay, so K equal to 3.3 for roller bearings, but in our question ball bearings is given, so that's why you have to consider K equal to 3 for ball bearings and substitute the value of W. Here the equivalent dynamic load value is given, that is 1 kilonewton, so W equal to 1 kilonewton, so that's why answer is also in kilonewton. And life of bearing L90 value is already obtained in previous slide. So L90 value is 10105 into 10 power 6 divided by 10 power 6 whole power 1 by K. K equal to 3. Okay, for ball bearings. Now the final answer for equivalent dynamic load rating capital C equal to 21.62 kilonewtons. Okay. Here the equivalent dynamic load W is in kilonewtons. Okay, that's why the answer also in kilonewtons. Okay, here the life of bearing in revolutions, and here 10 power 6 also in revolution. So here numerator and denominator both are same, so both are cancelled. So only the equivalent dynamic load value is in kilonewtons. So answer also is in kilonewtons. Okay. So this is the final answer for this problem. Okay. Now coming to the another problem, that is this one is a different problem. Select a single row deep groove ball bearing. Okay. Here the type of ball bearing is given. So here ball bearing is given, ball bearing. So that's why K equal to 3. Okay, the value of K equal to 3 for ball bearings. Okay, and here the type of bearing is given, that is single row deep groove ball bearing. So by using this type, okay, you have to consider the values of radial load factors and axial load factors. Okay, this is very important for considering the load factors. That means load factor X and Y values. Okay. Here the radial load value is given, that is WR. The radial load WR is given, radial load equal to WR, that is 4000 newtons. And axial load means WA, axial load or thrust load, WA is given. Here WA equal to 5000 and WR equal to 4000. Okay, here the value of axial load is more than the value of radial load, so thrust loads are very high. And the operating speed is given, that is M. Okay, this value means capital M. Speed of the bearing or speed of the shaft is given, that is N equal to 1600 revolutions per minute. RPM means revolutions per minute. Okay, and here the life of bearing is given, that is average life of 5 years 10 hours per day. Here the life of bearing is given in years. Okay, here we need to design a deep groove ball bearing for 5 years. Okay, for 5 years, 5 years, and working time is 10 hours per day. Okay, so by using this data, you have to convert this life in hours into life in you have to convert this life of bearing in years into life of bearing in hours. Okay, here uniform and steady loads are given. So these are the service factors. Already we have discussed in this session at the time of starting. Already we have discussed about this service factors. I will show the service factor for uniform and steady loads. So these are the service factors for uniform and steady loads. You have to consider Ks equal to 1. Okay, for uniform and steady loads, you have to consider service factor Ks equal to 1. Okay, so these are the given data values. So radial load WR equal to 4000 and WA, axial load, equal to 5000, and speed of the shaft equal to N equal to 1600 RPM. Okay, here first of all you have to convert the life of bearing into hours. Here the life of bearing is given in years. Okay, so that is 5 years is given, the life of bearing in years equal to 5 years. You have to convert this 5 years into days. Here I am considering number of working days per year as 300 days. Okay, so that's why you have to multiply with the 300. Okay, so 5 years as the working years, and you have to convert these 5 years into days, working days. So you have to multiply 300 days per year. Okay, so the total life of bearing in days equal to 1500 working days. Okay, this is the life of bearing in days. Okay, working days, 1500 working days. Then after you have to convert this working days into working hours. Okay, from given data, the working hours per day equal to 10 hours. So you have to multiply 1500 with 10 hours. Okay, then the life of bearing in hours is equal to 1500 working days into 100 hours per day. Okay, then the total life of bearing in hours, LH, is obtained. That is LH, life of bearing in hours equal to 15,000 hours. Okay, this is the our given life of bearing. Then after, you have to convert this life of bearing into revolutions. Okay, so for converting this life into revolutions, you have to use the speed of a shaft. Yeah, this is the revolutions per minute. For 1 minute, the shaft will rotate 1600 revolutions. So you have to use this value. The formula, already we know the general expression for life of bearing in revolutions equal to 60 into N into LH. Okay, 60 into LH means life of, LH means life of bearing in hours. You have to convert this life of bearing in hours into minutes. So that's why you have to multiply with 60. Okay, 60 into LH. 60 into LH means life of bearing in minutes. Then after, you have to multiply with N to convert this life of bearing into revolutions. Here, that N equal to 1600 RPM. Okay, and 60, this is a 1 minute. And this one is hour, 1 hour. Okay, so the total number of hours equal to 15,000 and 16, speed of the shaft equal to 1600. So you have to multiply these three values and the final answer for life of bearing in revolutions equal to 1440 into 10 power 6. Sorry, this is a 10 power 6. 10 power 6 revolution, that is 1440 million revolutions. Okay, and then after you have to find the value of radial load factors and axial load factor. This is the formula for equivalent basic dynamic equivalent load. Okay, so here the formula for dynamic equivalent load, W equal to X into V into WR plus Y into WA. Okay, here W is the equivalent dynamic equivalent load. Okay, here WR is the radial load, WA is the axial load. Okay, WR and WA, these both values are given in our question, but we don't know the values of X, V and Y values. Here the value of V, the value of V is equal to 1. Okay, for outer race stationary bearings. Okay, V equal to 1. Okay, and by using data handbook, we have to find the values of X and Y. Here X is the radial load factor, Y is the axial load factors. Okay, these X and Y values are coming from data handbook values. Okay, so in order to determine the radial load factor X and axial load factor Y, we require WA by WR ratio. Okay, first of all, you have to find the ratio of WA by WR, that is axial load by radial load. And also you have to find the value of WA by C0. Here C0 is the static load factor. Okay, C0. The value of basic static load factor C0 is not known. Okay, WA and WR, these both values are given in question. Okay, here WA also we know, but we don't know the value of C0. So first of all, you have to consider a suitable value. Okay, from data handbook, you have to consider. You can observe here our given problem is a deep groove ball bearing. Okay, so these values are taken for deep groove ball bearings. So these are the values for WA by C0 values. So here WA by C0 equal to, here I consider WA by C0 equal to 0.5. Okay, I consider here C0 value is not known. Okay, so that's why I consider the WA by C0 higher value. I consider the maximum value of WA by C0. So the maximum value is here 0.5. So WA by C0 equal to 0.5. I consider this value. This one is a maximum value. Okay. So the corresponding values, you have to consider X and Y values for corresponding WA by C0 and E values. Okay. Here X and Y values, here 1 and 0 for WA by WR ratio less than or equal to E. whereas x equal 0.56 and y equal 1 for WA by WR is greater than E values. Okay, so here the E, first of all you have to find out the value of E. Okay, so here now from data and book tables, we find the values of x and y corresponding to WA by WC, WA by C naught equal 0.5 and WA by WR. WA by WR, here the value of WA equal 5000 and WR equal 4000. The ratio of WA by WR equal 1.25. Okay, so which is greater than here, this value is E, 1.25 is the value of E, but here E equal 1.25. Here for a deep groove ball bearings, 1.25 is not there. Okay, E equal to 1.25, the value of 1.25 is not there in this row. Okay, so you have to consider the nearest value of 0.44. okay, okay, you have to consider the nearest value, it is 0.44 is the nearest value to the 1.25 value. So the values of x and y values you have to consider here. Our value 1.25 is greater than the 0.44. okay, here you can observe here our here 1.25, value of 1.25 is greater than the 0.44. okay, here the 0.4 our మనకు వచ్చిన వాల్యూ 1.25, కానీ ఇక్కడ ఉన్న వాల్యూ 0.44. ఓకే అండి, మనకు వచ్చిన వాల్యూవే పెద్దది, సో అంటే గ్రేటర్ వాల్యూ. సో మనం తీసుకోవాల్సిన టేబుల్ ఇది. అది మనకు వచ్చిన వాల్యూ కనుక 0.44 కన్నా తక్కువ ఉంటే ఇప్పుడు లెస్ దాన్ వాల్యూ అని తీసుకునేవాళ్ళం. ఓకే అండి, సో మనకు వచ్చిన డబ్ల్యూఏ బై డబ్ల్యూఆర్ అనే రేషియో 1.25 వచ్చింది. 1.25 అనేది ఇక్కడ లేదు, సో అది బిగ్గర్ వాల్యూ. సో 1.25 is greater than 0.44. So you have to consider this column. Okay, so the values of x and y values, you have to consider these two values. That is x equal to 0.56 and y equal to 1.0. You have to consider these two values because our 0.44 value is less than our obtained value. Okay, 1.25. So from data and book, the values of x equal to 0.56 and y equal to, okay, y equal to 1. Okay, x equal to 0.56, y equal to 1. And then after, you have to substitute the values of x, y and WR, WA. Here V is the rotational factor. Okay, this value is almost 1. Okay, so you have to substitute the values of x, y, V, WR, WA values. Here the answer for W equal to 7,240 newtons. Okay, and then after already we know the formula about the basic dynamic load rating, that is capital C. By using this formula you have find out the value of capital C. Here W capital W value is 7,240 and L is the life of bearing. Already we found that value, life of bearing in revolutions, that is 1440 into 10 power 6. Okay, and 10 power 6 is constant, and here 1 by k equal to 3 for ball bearings. Okay, in our question ball bearings is given, so you have to consider k equal to 3 for ball bearings. And the final answer for capital C equal to 81.76 kilonewtons. okay, this is the answer for a basic dynamic load rating. Okay, then after you have to find the suitable bearing type. Okay, so here from data handbook, from this data handbook table, you have to find you have to select a suitable bearing number. These are the bearing numbers corresponding to our dynamic equivalent load rating value. Okay, so here here This is the dynamic equivalent load rating, capital C equal to 81.76. Okay, so you have to select a bearing number by using this value. You have to select a nearest value for 81.76 kilonewtons. Okay. Here, 81.76 is the, our value. Here, see, this column is a C for a single row deep groove ball bearing. So, here, so 90, I consider the value of C equal 90. Okay, this is our nearest value. This one also nearest value, but this value is less than our value. So this is the greater value. So you have to consider maximum value. So that's why I consider this value, capital C equal 90 kilonewtons. Okay, and the corresponding C naught value equal to 72. Okay, the value of C naught static load rating, C naught equals 72, and the bearing number is 315. Bearing number is 315. Okay, so for bearing number 315, C naught equals 72 kilonewtons and C equal 90 kilonewtons. Okay, then after by using this ratio WA by C naught value, you have to find out the value of 0. You have to find the ratio of WA by C naught. Okay, the answer is 0.07. And then after, by using this ratio WA by C naught value 0.07, by using this ratio, again you have to find the value of radial load factors and axial load factors, that is x and y values. You have to find the values of x and y corresponding 0.07 value. Okay, so here these are the x and y values. Okay, here the value of WA by C naught, WA by C naught equal 0.07. okay, here 0.07, this is the our value. So WA by C naught value equal 0.07. the corresponding values is equal to x equal 0.56 and y equal 1.6. okay, so by using these two values, here you can observe here x equal 0.56 and y equal 1.6 for values 0.07. okay, 0.07, the ratio of WA by C naught equal 0.07, the corresponding x and y values equal to this is a third 1, 2, 3, third row, that is this one 0.1.6 is the y value and x equal 0.56. okay, so by using these two values, you can find out the value of C, dynamic load rating value. Okay, capital C equal to W into L 90 by 10 power 6 whole power 1 by K. The formula is same. Okay, W into L life of bearing in revolutions divided by 10 power 6 whole power 1 by K. Okay, so here already the value W is already obtained in previous steps. This is the W, this is the life of bearing in revolutions. Okay, and K equal 3 for ball bearings. Okay, so this is the value of W. Okay, this is the formula for X into B into WR plus Y into WA. Okay, by using this formula, we have to find the value of W. Okay, W equal to 10240 and L equal to 1440 and 10 power 6 by 10 power 6 whole power 1 by 3 equal to, the answer is 115,635 newtons. Okay, this value dynamic load rating is in newtons, because the value of load is in newtons. Okay, the load is in newtons, so the units for dynamic load rating also is in newtons. And if you want to convert this newtons into kilonewtons, then you have to divide with 1000. Okay, then the answer is 115.635 kilonewtons. Okay, so then after by using this value, you have to select a suitable bearing number. Okay, again you have to, by using C equal to 115, okay, here C, these values are C for single row deep groove ball bearing. Here 104, 112, okay. Okay, by using data and book tables, you have to select a suitable bearing number. Okay, here I chose a number 319. Here the capital C for bearing 319, it having capital C equal to 120. That this value is nearest to the our value, that is 115.635. Okay. So it may be suitable for our requirement. Okay, this is our problem. And this is the last problem in this session. Okay, a single row angular contact ball bearing. Here the type of bearing is also ball bearing. That is K equal to 3. K equal to 3, and here single row angular contact ball bearing is given. Okay, so you have to design a angular contact ball bearing. Here the number, ball bearing number is given, that is a 310. Okay, here the bearing number is given, that is a 310 is the bearing number, is used for an axial flow compressor. So the application of the bearing is in compressor. The bearing is to carry a radial load. So here the load is given, that is WR. Okay, this is a WR. Radial load, that is WR. And axial or thrust load. Thrust load or axial load is given, that is WA. WA is given, okay. Assuming light shock load. Okay, here the type of service factor is given, that is shock loads, light shock loads. Okay, this value is KS. Okay, you have to find the value of KS service by using data and book. You have to find the value of KS for light shock loads, and also determine the rating life. That is K, that is C. You have to find the value of C. Okay. Now from data and look, first I am selecting the service factor value, that is KS, for light shock loads. Here for uniform and steady loads, KS equal to 1. For light shock loads, KS equal to 1.5. Moderate shock loads equal to 2. And heavy shock loads 2.5, and extreme shock loads equal 3. Okay, in our question, you have to select for light shock loads. So for light shock loads, you have to select KS equal to 1.5. Okay, service factor for light shock loads equal to KS equal to 1.5. Okay. So the given data is radial load equal 2500 and axial load equal 1500 newtons. Okay. So first of all, you have to find the ratio of axial load by radial load. That is axial load equal 1500 divided by radial load equal to 2500. The ratio of WA by WR, that is small e. Small e is obtained. Okay. This value is small e. Small e equal to 0.6. Okay. by using this ratio, you have to find the value of x and y. Okay, these are the x and y values, that is radial load factor and axial load factors. These two values are obtained from the data handbook at ratio WA by WR. Okay, I will find the value of equivalent dynamic load. Okay, so here WR equal to 2500, WA equal to 1500. Okay, substitute these two values and also substitute the values of x and y. Okay, so the answer is the equivalent dynamic load W equal to 2500. Okay, and here the service factor also we consider for light shock loads equal to 2500 into 1.5. This is the final equivalent dynamic load. Okay, so by using this value, you have to find the value of C. Okay, here the bearing number already is given in our question. Okay, the type of the bearing number is 310. Okay, so select a value of equivalent load rating, that is C. You have to select a value of C for bearing number 310. Okay, this bearing number already is given in our question. Okay, for angular contact bearings, so here these are the angular contact ball bearings. Okay, by using this column for bearing number 310, okay, this is the bearing number 310. Okay, choose a suitable value C naught and C value. Okay, these two values are our required values. So the C naught value is 40.5 and dynamic equivalent dynamic load rating is C, capital C equal to 53 kN.